Boris Effects Continuum 2024 has just been released. And if you use our tool inside of After Effects, we have a machine learning effect just for you. Inside our popular image restoration category, you'll find UpRes ML. Simply drag and drop this onto a shot in your composition, watch it scale up while preserving the fine detail. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can do this while preserving detail up to 400% in scale, also comparing it to the native scaler. Let's dive right in. I'm here inside of After Effects, and this is the clip that I'd like to apply UpRes to. Keep in mind some of the detail here in the light and the bubbles that you see in the background. And we can find this in the image restoration category. Here's UpRes ML. Let's drag it onto the clip. Now, a word of caution. If this is the first time that you are applying UpRes ML, it's going to take a little while to initialize. The same is true of our denoise filter that also works inside of After Effects and all of the other hosts as well that Continuum supports. Once it's finished this first initialization, then it's going to work and be optimized for your system, working much faster. So I can see here that it's scaled up my clip 200%. And we also include a center position where we can change the framing of the UpRes clip. So let me increase that in the y-axis, and let's pay attention to the bubbles as well as the detail here in the light. And the best way to compare this is, let me duplicate this clip here in the composition, and on the duplicate, remove UpRes. And this time I'll just scale this natively, knowing that the native scaler does not have AI. So I'll reposition it too. I'm gonna now turn off the native scaled clip next to the UpRes version. One other thing to note, that inside of your workflow with UpRes, you might not just want to scale in on a clip inside of your composition, but make a clip larger as well as export that. We've got you covered with a property there as well. So to show this on the UpRes clip, first of all, I'm going to go to my composition settings. Noting that this clip is HD, I'll make the composition ultra HD. So double the size, and we'll see here that UpRes doesn't expand beyond the boundaries of the 1920 by 1080 raster until you click on the allow resize option. Once I recenter this clip by resetting it, now it takes up that full ultra HD frame, and I can go and render this out either using media encoder or just directly inside of After Effects. Let's take a look at another example. Okay, here's the new shot with the piano and a lot of highlights. I can zoom in just to sort of see those details. I'll type in the word UpRes. Let's select BCC plus UpRes ML from that image restoration category. Let the filter get to work. And let's just take a look at the results here of a 200% scale up. In addition to being able to change the scale in the center, we also have an amount of sharpening that's been added to our clip. We can increase and decrease this depending on our needs. So in this case, in fact, if I upscale this to 350%, I'll now increase my sharpening to just 45. We should see that there was slightly more detail brought back into the piano. So here is the before of the original shot, and here is the after with the upscale. Now I just want to do one more thing. I'm going to take this original clip and actually just use the host upscaler. So that's it at 350%. I'm going to take a snapshot. Now bring this down back to 100%, enable UpRes, and then just let's take a look at that snapshot. This is the host, and this is the UpRes results. Look at the detail inside of the highlights along those poles and the piano. And that's how we can use BCC plus UpRes ML inside of Adobe After Effects within Continuum 2024. This release has a ton of other new features available in all hosts, including Audio Visualizer, as well as another machine learning tool, our Denoise ML. For more tips and tricks like this, check us out at borisfx.com, and don't forget to subscribe.